events like this and many more into the future, maybe bigger events, will turn the tide back, because I agree with the Senator, unless we stand up and fight back, I think the chilling effect, as you mentioned already, where people will start to censor themselves for fear that they may be prosecuted, is very dangerous for society, because it means that there is only one narrative, and that would be the narrative coming from the state. And the narrative from the state is the one that comes from the NGOs, because as we all know, the state are constantly pandering to NGOs all the time, and that's why we see this type of legislation being brought in. Nobody agrees, by the way, with hate speech. Nobody agrees with encouraging violence. That goes without saying. But in saying that, people need to be free to be able to say what they want. And the problem is that communities, smaller communities of people, be they gay people, be they LGBT people, be they a different nationality or a minority, just because you say something about them doesn't mean you hate them. It just means you may disagree with some part of the system. They may take that as hate, and you might find yourself in front of a judge deciding whether it is or not. And the fact that the minister won't define the word hate is even more concerning, because it means that she was asked and given a few examples. In other words, it's up to her to decide what I say, and it's up to her to decide if I, whatever I've said is offensive or hateful. That's not the way society works. It's like a thought police.